Uncensored. You are now rocking with the best. Make sure that you follow us on social media. Also, share and hit the like button for the best sound in the industry. Go down in the description box and get you a pair of Beats headphones right now. And now for our feature presentation. News Uncensored. You are now rocking with the best. Make sure that you follow us on social media. Also, share and hit the like button for the best sound in the industry. Go down in the description box and get you a pair of Beats headphones right now. And now for our feature presentation.
What's going on, man? We in here, man. We about to get right to this. The people demanded that we be here and cover this. So we in the building today on this Sunday. We about to get it in, man. So we get news today. You know that Tekashi 6ix9ine, everybody's favorite internet troll bully, been doing this thing, you know, in the music, you know, a lot of Billboard charts, you know, number ones, you know, killing them out there. But we get word now from TMZ that Tekashi 6ix9ine was kidnapped, pistol whipped, and robbed, and is now in a hospital. Now, sources close to Tekashi tell TMZ that the rapper was working on a music video early Sunday morning around 4 a.m. in Brooklyn when he wrapped up the night and drove home. And he said when he got there, a car pulled up and blocked him in his driveway. And they said it was three men with hoods that came, you know, pistol whipped him, beat him up unconsciously. Now he's in the hospital. Now they're saying that they took about $750,000 in jewelry, $15,000 and $20,000 in cash. You know, now also his baby mom and his little daughter in there were in the crib, but they were not hurt. Yeah. A lot of people are speculating that she may have been set up. We'll get to that, you know. But Sam Ant. Now, here's the picture everybody can see on the screen right now. It looks pretty bruised up. It's a lot of stuff going around. People saying it's a hoax. People saying his girlfriend set him up, allegedly. He's going to put it out there. And we talked about this.
Yeah.
We talked about this. And first and foremost, I want to say that I'm not happy to see anybody, you know, get hurt. But no, I'm just gonna let you talk about this, man. Go ahead, man.
So when you called me this morning, so we sitting there, I'm walking my dog, I'm chilling, doing my thing.
Right.
You hit me up like, yo, did Tekashi get fucked up last night? I'm like, I don't know. I ain't really looked at nothing. I doubt it.
Mm-hmm.
He's notorious for being a troll. He's notorious for putting news out there to gain attention.
Mm-hmm.
So this is what he does. I wasn't really putting anything serious into it. Then you start looking, you're like, nah, motherfucker, this shit's real.
Mm-hmm.
You start reading it, like, oh, damn. Then you start looking into the details. And it's like, you're going to have a lot of people, although this was real scary on a number of accounts. His baby was involved. His wife was involved.
Mm-hmm.
He was kidnapped. A lot of things that are very scary happened throughout this ordeal. No one's going to care. A lot of people are going to laugh at this situation, say he got what's coming to him. He got exactly what he deserved because he went out to Chicago and disrespected. He went to Houston and disrespected. He went to LA and disrespected. All this kid has done throughout his career is disrespected other people. So who does he have to blame but himself? But when you really look at the situation, it's sad.
Mm-hmm.
Because you got a kid who's really not about that life.
Mm-hmm.
Great talker. You know what I mean? Really cool. Getting under people's skin.
Mm-hmm.
Got a buzz. Really pissed people off, and he was winning from it. He just had a single he dropped with Nicki Minaj, starting to mm-hmm. do his thing mm-hmm. at studio at 4 a.m. in his own city. That should be noted. In his own city, the king of New York. This happened in Brooklyn.
The king?
The king.
That's what he calls himself.
The alleged right. king.
Yeah.
And this happened right there. And he should be counting his blessings right now that he's not dead for real. Because there's people out here, like you said, or like I said, in Houston, in Chicago, in L.A., if they would have got a hold of his ass, it would have probably ended in a different and more tragic
way. It would have. What up? Because it's like, all you got to do, everybody knows, like, YouTube is one thing, but you have other social media outlets. You got Facebook, you got Twitter, and you got Instagram. It goes down in the DM. It goes down in the comment section. And I've seen people, and everybody say, I've seen people even tagging this dude, you know, especially when he went to Chicago, he offended a lot of real street G's, you know what I mean? And even definitely in Houston, mm-hmm. you know what I mean? And in LA as well. And a lot of people got that in the back of their mind. And it's ironic that it happens right there in his own backyard, because it's like, we seen the message. I showed you some messages that people sent him. I'm not going to repeat, but people have threatened this man's life. I'm sure he gets death threats every day. You know what I mean? And I said, you know, it was going to be serious, because when you go to places like Chicago, and not only, you know, are, you know, you're disrespecting different sets, you might be starting gang wars with other gang wars. But now I see him on Instagram, you know, disrespecting WAC 100. And they supposed to be both on the same, you know what I mean? So I'm like, this dude is like, has no respect, you know, for anybody, no matter where he goes. And a lot of people are, I know in the comment section, when his video is posted, a lot of people are going to be excited and saying, you know, he got what he deserved. And like you said, he's lucky he's still alive.
Is this a hoax? A lot of people right now in the comment section, and we always say that the comment section is the eyes of the street.
Yes, sir.
Everybody out there dropping that real shit in the comment section.
Yes.
So is this a hoax, man? Is this something that he's setting up? You know what I mean? We got the picture of him in the hospital. It's real. It's, mm-hmm. it's nice. It looks bad.
Right.
But we all know how the power of makeup and the set.
Hollywood, definitely. Hollywood,
you feel me? So is this a hoax? Is Tekashi 6ix9ine really sitting in the hospital in a fucked up situation right now?
I don't know, man. You know, I wouldn't put it past them. I wouldn't put it past none of these cats. You know, even with the whole 50 and Floyd, you know, that's a whole nother thing we'll get into in a few minutes. But it's like, I don't know, man. You know, people really want to put hands on this kid. And I think people are really gunning for this kid at this point, just even maybe to make a name for themselves, you know. So could it be a hoax? Possible. But I don't think so. I think this shit is very real.
I think it's real, too. And I don't think that they were they had any intent on murdering him. They wanted money and money alone and probably scared the shit out of him. And I think they did the job. I mean, them guns are probably loaded. They were probably ready for it. But if they had intent on killing him, they could have easily done it. We've seen how he was scrambling. It's crazy how it went down. They had him in the backseat, had him in his house while he's in the backseat.
Mm-hmm.
And they're in there kind of going through the crib. Just imagine that situation. And then he go back and they start driving more. He gets out. That's nuts, man. He's really lucky and counting his blessings right now that he's alive. Do you think, mm-hmm. once this is over, what do you see for Tekashi 6ix9ine? Like I said, he just had the single that dropped with Nicki. He was on his way to really kind of going into another lane with the pop, and with Nicki Minaj, you enter a different lane in music.
Right.
We start doing singles with her, and he got into that. So what do you see the end result being for this young dude?
He better get 24-hour security protection from the Shadow Group. You know what I mean? Shout out to the Shadow Group, man. You know what I mean? But real talk, he better, you know, get 24-hour protection because, you know, again, like we said on the podcast, and I didn't even, you know, him trolling is one thing, but listening to the ears of the street, you know, actually hearing people talk about, you know, and we even talked about years going past, he might change his own image up and somebody seeing him somewhere down the line when he's old and gray and still wanting to do something to him because it's just like he just ruffled that many feathers and it's just not going to end up good for Tekashi. You know, I don't think, you know, he's going to have to, you know, protect himself way better than this. Even like Rich the Kid was saying, you know, and other rappers, you know, he had to admit that he got to tighten up his, you know, his security because he was just, you know, beat up too in his crib.
He was beat up. You seen Young XXX murdered a month ago. Mm-hmm. You seen the brother mm-hmm. out in Pittsburgh. I don't mm-hmm. remember his name, but he was murdered
right
out in Pittsburgh. So these young rappers and things like that, they have a target on their back. We seen Offset, and we're going to segue into that.
No doubt.
You know what I mean? But in the famous words of our man Jay Prince, Tekashi 6ix9ine, you campaign enough and your ass will eventually get elected. And it looks like he got elected. He's sitting in the hospital getting CAT scans as we speak. That's all I got to say.
Hope the kid, you know, turned on the other side, you know, but, you know, when you ruffle feathers, you know, this is what you get. You know what I mean? You get cooked. But this is Hip Hop News Uncensored. You know what I mean? You listen to the Uncensored Truth Podcast and Viral Hip Hop News Collaboration. We going in today with my brother Sam, man, over there. Everybody listening, please hit the like button to make sure that you share this video for us. Let me get into this Offset thing. Now, we know the other day, man, you know, I think it was Saturday night, if I'm not mistaken, when the story, Friday night, Offset, you know, he was driving and I seen the videos up and I seen people. So I'm like, damn, what happened with Offset? And I ain't believe it at first when I seen, but he was actually arrested, you know, driving. And the reason why they said they pulled him over because he did an illegal lane change or something like that. But when they pulled him over, they found some marijuana and they found a weapon in the car. So he was arrested, you know, detained for about 24 hours. He made bail. He posted $17,000 bail. So we kind of thought it was over. We was like, damn, you know, he took an L on this one. But Offset's lawyer, his lawyer is now coming out, Drew Fineland, saying that the police motives were accidentally questionable. You know, so now let's start with the weapon. The weapons, they're saying that they found an Offset car was actually, you know, in possession of Offset's bodyguard. You know, that's what they're saying. They also saying he was also licensed to carry a gun, you know, at the time. And they're saying even going back to the stop, they're saying that's even questionable. Like they shouldn't even have pulled him over. So his lawyer is pretty much saying that they're targeting him because he's, you know, a young black man that's rich. Sam, man, what do you think about this allegation? You know, Offset's lawyer coming out saying that they're attacking a young black African-American, you know, with jewels on top of the world. They're just trying to find something to get a headline on. What do you think about that?
I did the stories as they came out. Also,
yes, sir.
When he got locked up for it. And it, the first story came out that it was tinted windows. And it's pissing me off. How fucking stupid and ridiculous.
Right.
It's tinted windows. For real? Like, how the reasoning in tinted windows makes no fucking sense. And we know a lot of us have tinted windows, so it's just an easy and probable cause for a cop to come fuck with you if you got tint on your windows. It's one of the most ridiculous.